All right, everyone, we're doing another video here on Scale Insights, and you guys are going to be hearing this name a lot more because, like I said, we are using Scale Insights for all of our accounts moving forward. So if you're working with us, you know that we've already signed you up on this account. On the software, we really, really love it. And for all new accounts, this is what we're going to be doing moving forward. We want to start diving in to all of the specific options that you have in Scale Insights. And specifically today, we want to talk about dayparting. So really quickly, if you're not familiar with dayparting, it refers to the term where you can change budgets or bids, different days of the week or different hours of the day, right? Dayparting, different metrics. So what we've seen a lot of times, I know a lot of people split up bids a lot of the time, but we like to just focus on changing budgets. Everyone knows, if you think about it, Amazon Prime Day is usually on a Monday or Tuesday because those are some of the best days of the week. Friday and Saturday are the worst days of the week. Okay. So there's a lot that you can do with different days of the week. And you'll see Stefano already has this pulled up here. And he's just going to talk about some of the things to do with dayparting on Scale Insights. And there's so much more that we can cover, but we wanted to give you guys some specific examples.
Yes. As Lucas said, we don't like to change bids. We prefer to focus on the budget because for us it makes more sense. And here, thanks to this analysis, you can see this analysis under sales, dayparting trend, and day of week sales per product. So here for each product, you can see what is the average order, what are the average units, sales, profit, ROI, margins, and other metrics. Okay. And for this client, we have seen that for one product, in specific this one, as you can see during the weekend, so on Saturday and on Sunday, the margins dropped. Mm-hmm. And the main reason is that the conversion rate decreased a lot because for this the customer for this product, they are buying especially during the week and not on the weekend. So what we decide to do with the client is to stop all testing campaign. So not exact match campaign, but only phrase broad automatic campaign during the weekend. And with the scaling sites, it's super easy to do that. You need to go under automation. And then we need to go under daily budget rule here. And here you can create a new rule like this one, like weekend, no testing. So it means that in the weekend, we will not run any tests. So we will focus only on what we know that is working. In this case, exact match or product targeting campaign. And what do we do? We decrease the budget by 90% on Saturday for all this campaign. And on Monday, we increase the budget by 1,000%. So we are sure that on Monday, we are back on track with the budget. And this is very simple, but it's super powerful because we can save so much money and we can increase the profit like in really 10 minutes. We need only to set up this rule and then attach this rule to the right campaign. So in this case, we will attach the rule to the campaign.
Yeah. I just want to say something so important that you're mentioning is right, not touching exact match. Yeah. Because a lot of people, and that's why we're saying this, guys, is we like this tool because it doesn't say like, hey, lower all budgets by 90%. You don't want to touch your exact match best keywords, right? There's mm-hmm. a lot of campaigns, there's research campaigns. Those are the ones we're lowering. We're keeping our top of search for exact match. That's fine if we lose some money or lower conversions on those. If we turn those off for 2 days, we lose so much ranking. So that's what Stefano was saying is like, we're really taking this and segmenting it out, right? And like parting these campaigns because every campaign has a different goal. So I just want to really hit that home because that's the most important part of this.
Yeah, clearly.
So yeah, anything else? Did you want to dive into anything else with the day parting? I feel like this is really, it's like one good overview. And it's like you said, it's a really simple fix that doesn't take long, but it can make a big difference, right?
Yeah, you can analyze especially your bestseller first and see if you can apply the same rule or if you see some trend like this and do a very simple test because there are other features here, but we will discuss maybe in another video, like criteria profile or a budget baseline. But yes, this is a very simple but still advanced studies, so we can increase our profit and still maintain our ranking.
Yep, exactly. And every account's different. Like you said, Saturday, Sunday aren't good for this account. Sunday is the best day for a lot of people, right? So don't take our word for this. Look at your data. But this is what we're seeing on this account is we want to hit it hard during the weekdays. All right. So we hope this helped give you guys a little more insights into this software. And again, there's going to be a link in the description for you guys to check out because we really, really love this tool. There's a lot we can do with it. And we're going to keep coming to you with a lot more videos here.